Hey, yo, football is my first love, y'all. Football and then basketball, you know? So to be able to do videos about both and get so much support from y'all is amazing, and it means so much to me. The video before last, I talked about Patrick Mahomes and how special he is in the future of the Kansas City Chiefs. So shout out to all them real Kansas City Chiefs fans that supported that video. And I'd like to give a special shout out and welcome to my brand new subscribers and to all my OG subscribers that been here from the jump. Y'all already know what it is, man. But I'ma keep it 100% honest with y'all. I've honestly never gotten 500 likes on anything in my life, so it means so much to me to see how successful that video was. So let's keep this train rolling, y'all. Let's keep this train rolling. LA Rams fans, it's your turn. Drop my intro.
It's Killer Rams, we got the hottest staff. In 03, I made a dynasty like Robert Kraft.
Now, I don't know how this works because I'm not from LA or St. Louis. So I'm actually start this video off with a question for y'all. Now, all my true Rams fans, let me know down in the comments how this works. Since y'all team relocated last season from St. Louis to LA, did you guys follow the franchise or are you no longer Rams fans? And for the citizens of LA, were you guys welcoming of the Rams? Be honest now. Don't be trying to be on the bandwagon just because they're successful, because this team has been extremely hot this season. Coming from the relocation from St. Louis to LA that I talked about just a minute ago, then taking a QB by the name of Jared Goff with the first pick in the draft, then firing their head coach the following season, a head coach that's been there for God knows how long. And that started the Sean McVay era, whom of which is the youngest coach in the NFL. But the reconstruction from the ground up seems to be actually paying off, y'all. I've always said coaching is the most underrated aspect of sports. I believe coaches don't get enough credit because they're not physically the ones performing on the field, when in actuality, devising schemes to fit the skill set of your players and having the ability to put a player with a certain skill set in the right situation to succeed, to me, is physically performing. And that is what head coach Sean McVay has been able to do for this franchise so far. I mean, the turnaround for this franchise deserves to be mentioned and praised. Now, of course, the journey isn't done, but this team is on pace to do something special starting the second half of the season. First of all, the 8-0. The first 8-0 start since, well, ever. And the crazy thing is, the offense is pretty simple. Nothing complicated. Crafty, but not complicated. All they do is run that three wide receiver set in a single back formation. The Rams actually lead the league in three wide receiver set formation. They run a tremendous amount of motion to help the young QB Jared Goff identify the Mike linebacker and the coverages the defenses are in. Man, Sean McVay is so crafty with his play calling, it's ridiculous. He's probably one of the most aggressive play callers in all of football. I mean, did you guys see last week all the crap they pulled on special teams with that fake punt? And then the very next possession, they tried to fake punt it, shift the formation, tried to confuse the defense. I mean, it's magnificent to me. And it's also fun to watch. But even though the pass attack has been pretty good lately, they typically love to run the ball with that stud in the backfield that needs no introduction. Speaking of that stud, he's on pace to break LaDainian Tomlinson's single season touchdown record of 31. And is also on record saying he's shooting for that record. And it's very possible that he can actually break this record with less touches than LT when he did it. Now that would be impressive. Gurley has been so sensational this season, he's actually up for the MVP, along with his quarterback, Jared Goff. Speaking of Jared Goff, he's also had a tremendous leap in his career thus far. This is a guy who was drafted with the first pick in the draft during his rookie season, didn't look like who they thought he would be. Wanna know why? It wasn't because Goff wasn't talented, it was because he wasn't utilized the way he should have been due to bad coaching. That's what I mean when I say coaching is underrated. People even went as far as to call Goff a bust without even seeing him perform, really. I bet whomever uttered those words at the time regret that now, because Goff and Gurley have this offense rolling. They're currently a top three passing attack and the number one rushing offense in the league. Third in scoring at 33 points per game and second in total yards with 442 behind Kansas City. But as good as Kansas City's offense is, the LA Rams lead the league in fewest three and outs. That should tell you something about this offense. It's funny how pretty much the same offense offense looked so horrible a couple years ago, and now they could potentially win the Super Bowl. Can you say Sean McVay for Coach of the Year? I mean, I just think the Rams figured it out. In recent years, most teams try to load up while their better players are still on rookie contracts. That's kind of been a wave lately. The Rams realized how hard it is to pay everybody their worth and still be able to afford other important pieces. That's why they made all those free agent acquisitions this season. Marcus Peters, Aqib Talib, Sam Shields, and Ndamukong Suh, Brandon Cooks, and so forth. They had an immediate plan to go all in and bring that Lombardi Trophy to LA. They recently just added Dante Fowler to an already stout top 10 defense. That front seven is trouble, y'all. Suh, Donald, and now Fowler coming off that edge? Like that line couldn't get any better, right? The only thing they was kinda lacking at was an outside pass rush. Speaking of that line, they happen to have arguably the best defensive player in the league on it. His name is Aaron Donald. Don't know if you heard of him or not, but you want to hear something interesting about Aaron Donald this season? Wrap your head around this real quick. Even though the Rams like to move him around the line, Aaron Donald is naturally a defensive tackle. He leads the league in sacks right now with 10 of them, even though he's been double teamed on 70% of the defensive snaps taken by the Los Angeles Rams this season. Did y'all hear that? He's been double teamed on more than half of the snaps, and he still leads the league in sacks. Do you understand what this means? This man, Aaron Donald, is a dog. He can possibly win Defensive Player of the Year yet again. I wouldn't be surprised if this team held the top rusher in the NFL, the MVP of the league, the Defensive Player of the Year, and the Coach of the Year. That, my friends, would be the first time that happened in the history of the NFL. Let's see if y'all can do it, LA Rams. Let's see if y'all can do it. Now, the Rams have a tough matchup against the Saints this Sunday. That game could tell us a lot when it comes to this Super Bowl race, right? Unfortunately, this video will already be done by that time, so don't shoot me, y'all. But outside of this game, the Rams have a pretty favorable schedule going forward. So the sky seems to be the limit for this team and what they can accomplish moving on. But anyways, that's pretty much all I got for you guys. Please leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Also, please subscribe if you love sports the way that I do. Man, I remember having this feeling in my gut around this time last season about my Eagles, man. It's like that feeling that nobody can beat us and we was definitely gonna win it all this year. I'm sure it's a lot of diehard Rams fans that have that same feeling in their gut this season. So shout out to y'all, man. This team looks good, and this could definitely be y'all year. But anyways, it's been a doozy, y'all, and as always, OG out.